Alrighty, I think we're live with Paper Mario. We've got the game over here, the chat over here. And
yeah,
one of my favorite things about streaming a little earlier than normal is that there are a lot of people here who don't normally get to be here. So Bren says they've got class in 2 hours, so they're glad we're doing it early this week.
Yeah.
I think we're going early this week because you have work. Right?
Yeah, I took another shift.
That's the main reason. How do we sound, by the way, guys? We kind of rearranged the setup so we could sit on a couch and not be, like, crammed in the corner.
I like it.
So far it's way cozier. Yeah.
I'm gonna get
my shoes. Come on. Oh, is this the right version of Dolphin? Is that plugged in? I'm trying to get the GameCube controller to work. Bear with me for a second. Alright, Andrea, tell the story of how you watched him get hit by a car while I fixed the GameCube controller.
Okay, so we're running a little bit late today because I was on the Bay Bridge, you know, just driving, and then this motorcyclist kind of goes around me, which is cool, you know, that's what motorcyclists do. Mm-hmm. Did it stop?
Oh, I clicked the wrong button.
Oh, it's cool. So then this other guy starts, like, he's, like, merging like crazy, you know, like people do sometimes, and then the motorcyclist kind of tries to go around him. But then instead, the guy hits the motorcyclist, and nobody stopped, so I stopped, and... Oh, it's pointed at you now. It's okay.
I thought I'd be really sneaky and, like, turn the other monitor around.
That's cool. That was funny. So anyway, so I called the police, and I stayed with the guy for a little bit, and he said he was fine, but I'm not sure if he was actually fine, but he refused to let me call an ambulance, so he talked to CHP and talked them out of it. But, yeah, it was a crazy morning. I kind of ran about half an hour late because I'm upset because we didn't get the license plate. So they said that they couldn't do anything about it. I don't know. It's just so shitty. Like, no one stopped to help at all.
Except for you.
Except for me because, I don't know, it seems like it'd be obvious that people would stop because somebody's, like, on the ground.
On the bridge.
Dude. On the bridge. But, no. And then I just remember the CHP lady yelling at me, like, where are you? And I was like, at the bridge. And she was like, where on the bridge? And I was like, I don't know. On the bridge.
What are your GPS coordinates?
Yeah, I don't know. So anyway, that was getting here. Which every time getting here. Oh, yeah, here's Rosalina. I got Rosalina, too. She's really pretty. Okay, this is what she looks like.
Oh, shit. Let's see if it pulls focus on her.
Does it?
You might have to...
I don't think they can see or hear. Because they're speculating. Whoa. Look at her. I don't see it focusing, though.
Hmm.
It says we're speculating. Stop.
Did I not start it?
I don't think so.
It's no. Weird. It looks like it's live over there.
Hmm.
Alrighty. Maybe I need to refresh the chat. Have we been talking to no one this whole time?
Maybe.
It's totally possible.
That is also fine.
Alright, YouTube seems good. So that's promising. OBS?
Oh,
is...
okay, they can't hear us. Okay.
Cool. Alright, everyone was talking like we weren't there, which is weird. Oh shit, it's working. Cool.
Okay.
Now we can start this, for real.
Okay, cool.
A little behind the scenes action. Ugh.
Behind the scenes.
Literally, behind the scenes. Alright. Well, with that, I think we can... Come on, hand. That's a new door. Cool. Alrighty, we're gonna be looking at this screen, I think, so I should probably put it up here. Alright.
See if it works.
Cool! It's working!
Yay!
I just refuse to play this game without a GameCube controller.
No, yeah, you should.
And without the case to prove that it's... That's how the law works, right?
Yeah.
Perfect. Paper Mario. Alrighty, so we're picking up where we left off. I feel like the last thing that happened
was
I got to play as Bowser for the first time.
Yeah.
Snuck up on some dudes who were talking shit about me.
Oh yeah, the Koopas. The Night Koopas.
Yeah, they look so cool. I love that armor. Alrighty. Oh, cool. So we rescued our dad.
There's Koopy Koo. And there's, I think his name's Merrick Croup.
The old dude? Croup, Croup, yes.
Well,
that's fine.
There goes the game. Doesn't she not want him to leave, though?
Yeah, she's kind of sin today.
Cuts really deep. She kind of changed her mind.
Well, Coop's kind of proved himself, you know?
Yeah, now she said, I'll be here waiting for you to prove yourself. I thought he kind of did that.
Well, now he has to really prove himself. Like, he proved himself a little bit. I love her little shorts.
Just two separate legs on each side of the shell. Or do you think she wears them under the shell and then puts the shell on?
I'm a little confused about how Koopas seem to work in this universe.
Yeah, the way that clothes work, like, the hoodie that he's wearing, kind of, you'd think that that would make it harder for the shell to stay on his body. Whereas he wears his hoodie over the front of his shell, but she wears her shirt and pants under the shell?
Yes.
And then Dad's just going full shell. Maybe he's got, like, a pant leg in there somewhere.
Oh, I forgot to get the hats! I'll do next week.
Sir Wibbles is asking when we're streaming Dramatical Murder. It'll be 8 p.m. Pacific time.
So sad I can't make it.
Yeah. Maybe next week.
I will. A little next week. I'm covering for someone tonight.
Bear the magical match and furl it before the thousand year door. The Suki Hin says, Nick, does the lady have a name or a YouTube channel? No, you have neither.
Yeah, that's true.
This is Andrea.
Yes, hello.
She doesn't. I don't think you have a YouTube channel, do you?
I don't upload anything. I just use it to make really dumb playlists of things. Yeah.
Each crystal star shall point to the next. Is the Thousand Year Door in the sewers? Where was it?
It was in the sewer. Oh, Axel the Key says I look like a cool goth today. That's most days. Thank you, though.
I got confused and I thought you were saying that's the line of dialogue that this dude was about
to say. That dude is complimenting my cool goth look.
Well, he looks like, I thought you were going to say that he says, I look like a cool goth today. It would be a great, you know, like the way this game is written, that seems totally within the world of, that would make sense. He looks like kind of a cool goth today, too.
I like General White.
I'm excited to learn more about him in the future. I think I've got, like, a bunch, hold on, let me get my girl out here so we can start learning about people. Get a real party member for once.
I like hoops.
I know. Alright. There we go. Now this game can truly begin. Alrighty, so I need to go to the Thousand Year Door. I don't have any fast travel yet, do I?
No. You have to old fashioned way.
Just gonna hoof it. Is she saying that?
It's your mailbox.
Oh, it's my Game Boy SP.
Your mailbox SP.
Sorry, my mailbox SP. Oh, right, the email that we sent is Peach. Got it, okay.
With the computer that's in love with you and my favorite Nintendo pairing.
We're after the map. They want the crystal stars. Not positive. That's not gonna work. All Mario does is worry about her.
I mean,
the Goombella's reading the email over my shoulder.
I feel like she has to, because if not, then we would just have Mario's like,
Right, he doesn't really talk.
Yeah.
I wonder how different this dialogue is when you have Koops out.
Yeah, that's the one thing about this game is like, each partner talks differently, so every time you go through a cutscene with, like, a different partner, they say something a little bit different.
Right.
And I mean,
I'm sure it's, like, largely the same, because this is mostly just, like, exposition and stuff, but
yeah.
I feel like
though is different.
I got a mystery.
Whoa.
What the fuck is that?
I don't know. I actually don't know. I've never gotten that.
Dude. Do I use it? It seems like I use it in battle, because it says take a chance and find out.
Whoa. You can't check.
Yeah, well, I'll try it. Should I try it on this Goomba, or should I save it for, like, a real battle?
Oh, gosh.
I mean, once I use it, it's gone forever.
That's true. I mean, I can't. No!
Oh, I didn't make it to the spiky one, luckily. That was all part of my plan. I've never tattled a Goomba?
I mean, why?
I'm one of those. What do you mean, those people?
Gunslinger says to save it. To save the mystery item.
Okay. Underlings of underlings. That is totally rude. What is the book she has? Like, just an encyclopedia?
That's a good question. It's probably one of those Goomba University textbooks. Dude.
I'm getting good at this game, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Alright. I'm gonna fuck it up on the second one. Because I don't want to go to the spiky guy. Alright, fuck it up on the first one, I guess.
That was part of your plan, too.
God, I want the badge that lets me swap for free. That sounds amazing.
Oh. Hmm.
Oh, now that he's knocked down, he... Oh, shit, I can't attack him.
Yeah, you can't
do
anything.
And I can only hammer whoever's at the front of the line, right?
TrueFan1980 says that Goombella has a D&D monster handbook.
Yes, for this universe. This has more interesting monsters than D&D, though, so...
How? Wow.
Do you not agree?
I mean, I don't know.
Goombas? Look at them.
Goombas are pretty cool. I mean, I don't know. I play Pathfinder more than I play D&D.
But you play Thousand Year Door more than you play either of those.
It's true, but the monsters are really cool. Like, I really like the gelatinous, like, oozes.
Yeah.
They're really gross.
Like, the gelatinous cube is definitely cool.
I have a gelatinous cube right now, because I'm running an alchemist, and I carry a lot of oozes. Seeking says, Nick, I think you just made a lot of people mad. What did you do? Oh, because of D&D. Oh, duh.
Ooh.
I know, Bren. I didn't say anything.
Because I use the power smash?
Yeah.
For no reason? I'm all about badge life.
Oh my god.
Sorry.
Badges are good.
I just feel like I will have more and more interesting attacks the more badges I have. Like right now I just have multi-bounce for Mario and that's a little boring. Did I go over here? No, that puts me in the background.
Yeah, just keep going left. I like flower power, but that's just me.
Maybe next time. Nope, I'm not gonna even fight you. You're not worth it.
Yeah, they're not. They're really not. Ren agrees with me about flower power.
Davey29 says, this is a Mario game? Yes. Correct. Alright, I've got... Wait, that's the castle back there. I don't need to go there. I love these colors, man. Look at these colors.
This is a really pretty game. I like the little, like, green circles in the dirt. Or in the grass. Whatever.
Yeah, it's very polka dotty. Very, like... This was kind of when Nintendo sort of... It feels like this was around the time when they first discovered arts and crafts as an art style. Actually, Paper Mario 1 was the first game to do it. And then, oh, damn it. I think Yoshi's Story also kind of did the whole, like, felt thing.
I liked Yoshi's Story. Even though it was short, I really liked the Bone Dragon.
I like the... Shit! Video games are hard.
What was his name? Nibbles?
I don't remember. I remember the theme, the title screen music very fondly.
Of Yoshi's Island, the ba 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 ba.
Yeah, the Yoshi's Story one.
Oh yeah, that's Yoshi's Story.
Am I going the right way, Andrea?
Yes.
Okay, cool. I'm surprised I remembered.
You did a good job.
So, I see you. I see you.
Davey29 says, I thought the turtle tries to kill you, so why is it following you? Kinda odd.
Davey has, like, only ever heard about Mario games from other people. He's Cisco. He's my friend.
Really?
I'm talking about, Koops.
Yeah. Oh, okay, I thought it was, like, really Davey. You know Davey? Koops. Yeah, Koops is your partner in this game, because in this game, you have partners that go with you throughout the levels, and it changes... Per level, you have them all on your party, then you can switch them as it goes.
Hey, you.
Whoa.
Wow, that's pretty rad.
That's really cool. Is that just a sound? That's cool.
A sound?
Mm-hmm. It looks like it's a sound badge.
It has an ability, though. Doesn't the sound badge just change the sound? This has never succumbed to a first strike.
Yeah, but it looks like it has a little sound.
Yeah.
So it might do both.
That's cool.
Brenven says, badge power is awesome once you have the badges to make it super awesome, but early game abundant flower power is what keeps you trucking. Rasputin says, Yoshi's Island also had a vastly divergent art style, which holds up way better than what the norm during 16-bit gen.
That's true. The N64 era is full of ugly fucking games that don't hold up today, but
true.
That game was a 2D platformer, so they kind of it's kind of timeless the way SNES games are timeless. Alrighty. Alright. This seems so worth it.
I think it's worth it.
And it's like only I don't know how many badge points. 1, okay. Dude, fuck yeah. He's a great salesman. Here, guy. Come on, now.
I can't tell what... I thought she was, like, a gypsy who's, like, eating her hand. But I can't really tell...
He's holding a... Oh, a messenger bag. At first I thought it was a loot, but now that I'm looking at it, it's a messenger bag with badges on it.
Like, it looks like she's wearing, like, a mask, or maybe it's a dude. I don't know.
It's the villain from the fourth Paper Mario game that's not out yet.
Yeah. Oh, this is... You don't need to visit. We're lovely.
Okay.
Although I love Merlovely. You should visit Merlin.
So, the difference between now and last time I was here is I have the ability to turn into a little boat. Right?
No, not a little boat. You have the ability to turn sideways.
Oh, thank you. God, if it... Just the fact that we take a 1 week break would have totally... Or I could have gone to Merlovely and she could have told me. Is there a way to get that for me right now?
No. Oh, wait. I don't.
Oh.
Actually, I think so. I think I just lied to you.
It's alright. We'll get it on the way back.
I always wonder, like, what that looks like if you're actually there. Oh, dang.
What the backdrop looks like?
Yeah, like, what it actually looks like up close.
We could move the camera in Dolphin and check it out sometime.
But I mean, like, you know what
oh,
I mean?
Oh, to Mario?
Like, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, the fortune teller.
Mr. Guy. Mr. Eyeballs.
Oh, Renvin says you can't get it yet.
What? What is happening here? It's hard to imagine anything being worth all that scroll.
Hmm.
How many of the... It's a fortune teller?
Mm-hmm.
I'm gonna go with the cheap one for now.
Look at her little hands.
Yeah. Look at the little dance.
God, she's adorable.
Oh. I love the way the occult works in the Mario universe.
Yeah, it's not, like, spooky yet. It's like...
This is my favorite version of, like, witchcraft.
It's worth it.
It's worth it?
It says.
Ooh. You win with style.
Oh, okay, I remember what this is now.
So I should get it? People seem to say, take the expensive one.
Yeah.
I'm doing what Orange Vision says. Do I get in a different colored box?
No, I don't think so.
So far,
now you get in the box.
So far, this is not very special. It's exactly what happened last time.
Cash Quest says, that's the way I live life, at least. Which is funny, because his name is Cash Quest.
Alright, well, I don't super know what that did. We're under the folks up top in my fortune-telling shop. I see your fortune, but stop. Oh, she's not into me going behind the counter.
Oh, yeah, I hate when people do that.
Alright.
You're probably cursed now. You're probably gonna end up in a box with a little black key. And they're gonna need to ask other people to go get the little...
That's how it works. It looks like I need some sort of, like, wall-busting ability. Because it's got a cracked wall. See it?
Oh, yeah, yeah, so you totally do.
I'll get that later.
You don't have that yet.
Okay.
You need a 1,000-year door, because you have the new crystal star.
Yeah. Ooh. That's close.
Oh, you should equip that badge.
Oh, you're right. What are the, badges...
Does it make a noise? It's not a sound effect. What is it? still really good.
Yeah. What's better, power bounce or bounce an enemy forever?
Right.
So it takes 2 FP, lets me attack multiple enemies in order. I'm assuming that one's better because it costs 3 badge points. That's my reasoning.
That's a good way to go. That's how I am when I buy makeup.
You assume it's better. It's more expensive.
Yeah. Yeah. Which is wrong. Oh, hey, Fun Farts is dropping in for a second to say hi. That's Maria.
Oh. What's up, Maria?
Oh, you gotta, you can't go through here yet.
What the heck? I'm missing something pretty obvious, huh?
Yeah.
Is it this one? I feel like it's going to take me up to the surface.
Yeah, that one does. I don't remember where to go now all of a sudden.
I love those scene transitions, though.
They're really nice.
What the fuck is Luigi doing here? Before I take care of that.
Oh my god, this is a good idea. Such a good idea.
What do you know about him? Who's this guy? That's your brother, Luigi.
Oh, I'm so excited. I love Luigi in this game.
Kawinky dink. That doesn't sound true. I would play the fuck out of that game, though.
That should be what the new Super Luigi is going to be about.
Yeah. Yeah, I definitely do, actually.
Alright, here we go. Gunslinger says L9.
L9. Lawful Kingdom letter. Whoa. He's got a song.
He does.
My big brother, that's you. That's a crazy thing to say to your big brother. Cooking a snack.
Dang, Crepe is trying to swoop on Mario. I'd like to see what Princess Eclair looks like.
Is Mario falling asleep?
Yeah, him and Gabelle are both sleeping.
I need the stay awake mask from Majora's Mask right now. You can hear him soaring.
Yep. My favorite thing about Luigi's stories is that, like, this is his story about how the story started. Mm-hmm. Yes, Paper Luigi 2016. Such a good idea.
God, I put the shit out of that.
Me too.
Year of Luigi 2. A marvelous compass. This is like an alternate plot for the game that they didn't use.
I really hope so. Axel of the Key and Ren Ren said they're getting lag.
Weird. It looks like we're good right now. Oh yeah, there. Alright, we're back.
Okay, cool.
Weird. The internet's just being super janky. Alright, seems like we're stable again, though, at least.
Haru wants a pizza. Oh, go ahead.
Rumble Bum Volcano in the Pudding Continent. I want this game to be real.
I know. Just wait until you, like... Every time you visit Luigi, he has a new story.
That's excellent.
Yeah.
Alrighty.
Haru177 was talking about either Paper Luigi or Paper Peach.
Oh, Paper Peach would be so good.
I would love Paper Peach.
There needs to be, like, a good standalone Peach game. Like, was it called Super Princess Peach? Was that the...
I remember one coming out, but I think it was called that, actually, yes. And a little girl came and bought it, and I thought it was really cool for some reason.
There's some really great sprite work in that game. Like, if you look at some of the art from it, it's amazing. My understanding is it's not an excellent video game. And also, like, it's kind of fucked up that they give Peach her own game, and her power is, like, crying.
Oh, that's really dumb.
Like, what's in here? Got these new powers.
Peach's power should be to show Tech what love is.
Yes, agreed. Ow, Jesus.
I see Maria mentioning Axel, and I'm just not gonna dignify her with any kind of acknowledgement, except I just did. It's a long story, I'll tell you later.
Alrighty. I don't think I can do this right now, I'm not fast enough. It's not worth it. Oh! Goombella just straight died.
Some nerd says that you use the power of your uncontrollable emotions. I'm assuming it's Super Princess Peach.
Yeah.
That's
which,
the worst.
There's a way... on the one hand, I guess it's there's a way to interpret that where you're like, I guess that's kind of nice. Maybe. Like, they're embracing what makes her... I don't know. It's probably just shitty and sexist, right? I don't... It's tough to say.
Hari177 used the term dubious gender politics.
Yeah. Yeah, like, it's... I want to give them the benefit of the doubt and say that it's like they're reclaiming the power of her...
It doesn't sound like it.
But it's probably just Japan being kind of sexist.
I like Peach in this game, though. I think Gabella is the best, though. I don't know. Gabella's a really good female character. Right. I mean, although she does show up and immediately need your help. But, you know, that's in the past.
Oh, this fucking guy. Well, do you see that? I struck first, just even though he touched me.
Oh, that's so cool. That is such a good badge.
You just, like, lazily stroll through the game and... Wait, have I not, had her look these guys up before?
I don't think so. I want to say they have 3 HP. Though. And they have 0 defense, if I'm right? I don't remember.
Thin paper boards.
Whoa. Yeah!
Good memory.
Thank you.
Give it a hee-yah.
What does that mean?
Like a karate chop?
Oh, I guess so. Oh, that's cute. That's a little... Isn't that the bird from Yoshi's Island? That little emote?
It is, yeah. Some of the emotes people get away with, I'm very surprised by.
God, Gabella's so cute.
She's awesome.
I stare at her. I'm glad she's out.
I wish she was a better, like, fighter. Kinda, because only because like I want to have her with me all the time and not have to like switch during combat. Is this right? No, this is where I got the fold up powers.
You're almost there.
Well, it's backtracking, dude.
That's cool. Official Pixelon says, "Hey, I might have a surprise for you and Andrea soon. Hope you liked the wallpapers."
Oh, thank you. Yeah, I checked those out last night. They're great.
They're super dope. Thank you.
Oh, here's a 1,000-year door. Cool.
Yep.
And then we can check out what's up at that spring in a second. Actually, I'm gonna check it out now.
Yeah, thank you. I don't think he can peel it yet.
Yeah, I think that's a later ability. Alright. Let's activate.
I always feel bad if I do this and Gumbella isn't out, because I feel like we started the journey together.
Yeah.
She should be here for
this. She deserves this moment. Where do they go when they're not with you? Do you just fold them up and put them in your pocket? Yeah.
Oh, that's a good point. Maria wants to know if you attack first when you already have the badge, does it do extra damage? I don't think so. I think it just negates other people attacking you first.
Yeah, I that would be a lot of power to put on one for one badge point.
Yeah, you know? Yeah, that would be a lot.
All right.
Here we go. Great Boggly Woods.
Wow, that's a really cool looking effect. Mm-hmm. There's a lot of those in this game. Like, a lot of the scene transitions in particular I'm noticing today are just, like, so cool.
I'm still impressed at how well this game stands the test of time. Like, it still looks like a recent game.
Yeah, like, we were talking about a... story, but you want to talk about a game that just has a timeless look. I think this game will look beautiful forever.
Yeah, it really, I think so too. It's the style. And I feel like there's so much attention to detail.
I love how this game is also unafraid to, like, cut away from Mario's journey and, like, take you to other scenes and other places.
Mm-hmm.
It makes it more cinematic that way, kind of.
I agree.
Does the professor have some, like, dope badges up on that shelf?
Actually, I just noticed those as well, and you'll see them later. You'll see those symbols.
Alrighty.
Oh my god, I didn't notice that. That's really cool. Actually, for those of you who have played this game before, if you notice Professor Frankly in the background, it's zoomed out right now, so you can't really see it. But when you see the whole room, at the very top right corner of the screen, there's a lot of symbols that we're going to encounter soon, actually. That's really interesting that it's in his room. I don't know why it would be. I wonder what that means. It's so cool. Yeah, really uncool. I was just about to just redo that.
Don't be hasty. If you want health or items, drop by the shop. Alrighty. I'm glad I didn't have to walk all the way back here after doing that, though.
Yeah, that is really nice.
There's a pipe that leads to Boggy Woods beneath the town. Look for that. Oh, so wait, I do have to go back.
Yeah, you do.
Oh, well, shit. Alright. I feel like I'm gonna fight him. I'm better now. I'm more powerful.
I think you can do it. Yeah, he's nothing. Oh, no!
Oh,
no.
Shit! Whoops.
Oh. He should probably coops it.
Wait.
Yes.
He's gonna throw a rock. Fuck out of here. That Goomba on Goomba violence.
That was Goomba on Goomba violence. No.
Alrighty.
That's not bad.
Aw, rude.
Oh, cool though, you're electrified now.
Oh, I'm tight.
To be honest with you, I would switch with Koops to be in front.
Oh, I didn't realize I could do that. Oh, and he'll take damage? Mm-hmm. That's a really major component of the game that I had not...
Really?
...figured out, yeah. Huh, cool.
Yes! Finally, it finally happened. Is this the first time this has happened?
We got a bingo before, but it wasn't for flower power, I don't think. Wow, the controller just rumbled a lot.
Yeah, it's because the audience was, like, running in.
It affects everyone?
Let's do it.
I have to know.
Whoa.
You wanna? Oh,
no, do it.
I don't think it's
anything. Oh, that sucks. Oh.
Oh!
Oh! Cool.
I got re-electrified?
No.
Nice.
That was awesome.
Zeus.
Yeah, Zeus just came out of nowhere to save you. I wonder what the Mario Mythos is.
Oh, like, what are their gods?
Yeah.
Are the seven stars the gods, maybe?
I feel like they're instruments of the gods, maybe.
Oh, he threw his spear for the first time. Interesting. This has been an interesting battle. A lot has happened so far.
It's actually very true.
Ganon
says... Sorry, go ahead.
Oh, no, it's fine.
Afterpower's like, how long have they been playing? Gosh, 12? 10? We've only gotten a little bit through Rogueport.
Yeah. According to our in-game timer, we are 4 hours into the game. We've been streaming today for probably 30 minutes, maybe? Not that long.
Hmm.
Wow. Rick Twitches says, it's currently 94 degrees here in Chile. This stream is the only thing saving my sanity.
Whoa.
I'm rooting for you. You dumb video game... Oh, look at that little meta-humor. Have we talked before about how... awful it is when video games say, what do you think this is, a game?
Yeah.
It's the worst. I was playing Life is Strange. At the end of that game, they literally have a line where this girl, in a really dramatic piece, she's like, this isn't a movie or a video game, and I'm just like, stop, it's so cringy, it's not clever. Mario
sometimes
could do it, though.
Funny.
I like it here, because he's like, you video game characters, and it's the only time they break the fourth wall in that way.
Yeah. I like when they do it in Kid Icarus Uprising.
Yeah, that game, I like the writing in that game, too.
Mm.
I just got my copy of that back, because I can...
Yes.
That's a fucked up looking Shy Guy.
That is a bandit. That is a... What are they called?
It's a fucked up Shy Guy.
I'm mad.
Ishnail and the Robos. swindle.
Yeah, just bandits.
Arthur.
That's Arthur right there. The Dugan. Is that Arthur, or is he the other Dugan? Let's see. The other one's Lazy Dugan. Yeah, that's Arthur.
The Trouble Center?
Mm-hmm.
Can I, like, pick up hits on people?
Yes. No. That'd you can so solve people's problems.
Poor Mario, he's hurt right now. Oh, wow. Look at all these quests.
Doing these quests is really fun, actually. There's some that are... You'll need to eventually make money for... God, I forget what.
Fire flowers, sleepy sheep, and tasty tonics. Alrighty. I'm gonna go check that out and also hit up the inn.
It's a good idea.
Fire flowers, the sheep, and the tonics, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
I think, was there...
Did I just run past the inn?
Official Pixelon... No, it's right there. Says, Dugans look like a Yoshi Papa and a Goomba Mama loved each other very much.
Yeah, exactly. Well put.
Oh yeah, I forgot you have the...
That is the best getting into bed animation ever. It also solves the problem of, like, if you notice, in every open world game you've ever played... They never show the character getting into bed. So, like, every GTA, Sleeping Dogs, every game, like, when you walk up to the bed and press the button, the camera, like, pans away or fades to black.
Red Dead Redemption.
I think, generally, what happens, he might lay down, but generally, like, it's actually a really huge burden to try to animate, like, sheets moving and everything, and it's not worth it, so they just, they hide it. This game, they don't hide it. He really gets under those covers, you can see it.
It's also kind of just, like, yeah. Slides. Jesse's asking if this earlier stream is going to be a regular thing, and I hate to say it, but I think it kind of relies on our work schedules.
Yeah. We'll always let you know on Monday if it's, what the fuck? The fevered look of a man with a mind for... I do have a mind for goods.
You don't have the money for goods.
Stylish commit.
Whoa! That
Holy
sounds
shit.
Awful!
Shit. Yeah. No thanks.
Just by one?
If it was, like, three or something?
Yeah. Especially because hammer is so important. Like, what happens if you have...
A bunch of spinies, yeah.
Yeah.
That doesn't sound like very fun.
Though. Oh, yeah, you can't go over there yet because you still don't have Zesty's contact lens.
Alright. So, tonic is three. The sheep is eight. And
mushroom.
Yeah.
Is five.
Five, three, eight. 538. Got it.
That toad in there, like, I can never tell if his... It looks like a mouth to me, but I know it's a mustache. But it'll always look like a little mouth.
538, 538,
538. Oh, really quick, before we go, we should... Oh, never mind. Do your trouble.
Right. Oh, there's fire flowers.
It's
well,
okay,
that's
it's
10.
Eight. That was pretty easy.
Sick. I don't know that he should just be sparing 20 coins when he's trying to open a shop. Hey, sorry, what were you saying that we should... Oh shit, something
out. What's up?
I can go...
Oh! He solved a thing.
Yeah. Okay, now you can tell me...
No, it's okay. I'll tell you before we go. As long as, like, we don't go to the woods before we do what we need to do.
Danger is good.
Danger is good.
I don't have the boat ability yet, do I?
No. Wow.
He's thinking of Wario, actually.
Yeah, he said, wah.
I'm not the one who goes wah. We get people get us confused a lot. This guy's cool. He's hospitable, though.
Yeah, I like this guy. He's you know, he's like, we don't have much, but, you know.
We'll get that later. Just now I know where it is.
I like hearing Andy run through the house. It's incredible, actually.
Yes. Oh, apparently there's a free shine if I jump on that second spring back in the near the Thousand Year Door, according to Epic KKR fan on YouTube.
I believe it. I forgot what it was exactly. We should go in that little house right there next to Luigi.
So many magicians in this world.
They're really specific, though, about where you have to be.
Use multi-bonk to attack a foe multiple times. Use shell shield to protect Mario.
Personally, I don't care for shell shield, but having... Honestly, I don't know. What do you guys think we should power up?
I mean, I was just saying, I wish Goombella had more attack power.
Yeah, she does, but for the next world.
I'm doing it. It costs 3?
Mm-hmm.
They all cost 3? So I just happen to have enough?
Mm-hmm.
Shizubi. Oh, fuck! Shizubi.
Yeah, this is a cool animation.
Oh, jeez. Oh, the way that people flip over when they rotate.
Goombella looks like she's thinking hard.
Yep.
Half of Power says, is that a mustache or a beard? I'd say mustache.
Yeah, it's like
a mirrored.
Old West giant mustache.
Okay, multi-bonk.
Oh, fuck, whoa. Look at that fake wall.
Yeah, I know.
How did I find that?
I don't know.
I was very lucky. See, this is a 3DS game I would have been able to tell. I'll bop ya! Dave Lang.
Alrighty. I love that.
Oh, fuck.
There he is.
Little zombie peasant boy.
I was going to be in for Halloween like 3 years ago. And then I was like, no one's going to know what I'm doing.
That is you.
Yeah.
Whatever powers you up is what they say.
Know what I mean? Universe.
Sick!
Hey, you're finding a ton of stuff today.
This is going great, yeah.
It really is. You found Darkly.
There's so many. Like, all these characters have names and stories. It's crazy.
Isn't that cool? Zombie Link, says Swimmaster 9001.
I think he does get a thrill from breaking the law.
I think a lot of people get a break from, or get a thrill from breaking the law in this town.
So there's a pipe that I need to take.
Mm-hmm.
I'm gonna do it.
Okay, so we powered up. Did you buy any items?
Yeah, let's do that. I just made some money. Let's go shopping. Adam Collier says, hey, female friend, who's your male friend?
I don't know. He just kind of shows up sometimes.
Shows up flipping Mario.
Yeah, at his own house. I love being female friends. Maybe my greatest title yet.
Female friend. Just change your name on Twitter to that for a day.
Female friend.
This fright mask. That's kind of cool sounding.
I do like the fright mask, actually. I think it's a pretty cool item. Did you get a fright mask?
No.
I want you to see it, like,
yeah.
Use. It's cool.
Alright, I'll buy that. I got 3 shopper's points. So if you kind of have a favorite store... Wait, so you see that mustache as a mouth?
I see it as a mouth, and I can't stop seeing
he's
it
like
as a mouth.
Horrified?
Yeah. He constantly looks really upset to me.
It is kind of the same color as his, like, eyes.
You see what I mean? Like, it looks mouthy.
It does. Oh, now and he's got, like, 2 little fangs?
Yeah. I'm glad you see it now, too. It's a problem, actually.
Alrighty. This is so fucked up. I'm almost surprised they left in the noose.
I know, really. Remember they took out the little, like, chalk mark of the dead toad? I love little trivia like that. I'll try to look up more next time.
Oh, fucking contact radio. Okay, so I gotta go to the right for a while.
I love the Rogue Point theme. Gunslinger also thought that was a mouth. It wasn't just me.
A few people did.
Cool. Awesome. It's mouth looking.
You need to patch that.
It looks like a mouth.
Alright. So, there's a pipe. Somewhere.
Don't think it's not going to be this way.
I already went here.
Apparently, Semen Demon says, nice handle, by the way. The dark stains by the gallows used to look even bloodier in the Japanese version.
Whoa, really?
I also love the remix of the Rogue Point theme in Smash Bros.
What stage is it on?
It's in the Paper Mario stage.
It's Paper Mario stage?
Yeah.
What?
Yeah.
Smash.
3DS.
Oh, wait. Hold on.
It's like there's a window. And it...
I like, as soon as the Wii U game came out, I forgot about every stage except for the really pretty purple one.
Yeah, you need to... This isn't the right way.
Fuck.
Are you talking about Magikant?
Yeah, Magikant. The Earthbound one.
Yeah, it's this one.
I wish I was at the...
I like the Dr. Wily stage.
So it's not that way.
Yeah, you
not...
need to... yeah. No, wait. The other pipe.
This
not
one?
That, no. The other pipe on the left.
On the left. Ah, word. Okay.
You'll know. There we go. Actually, now you can just, like, yeah.
Shortcut.
Yep. Nope. That's gonna be, like, remember when you were asking about the fast travel?
Yeah.
It's gonna be that.
Okay. Oh, here we go.
Yep, there we go.
She's got a good... Maybe he's good at descriptions.
The...
Okay. He can talk?
Mm-hmm. I love the music for peonies.
Guess again, nerd.
Say it.
Imagine Mario saying, guess again, nerd, to anyone.
How does it sound, even?
Guess again, nerd!
Yeah, sounds like that. Oh yeah, this is an X Not Heavy level. Which is exciting, because I love the X Nots. I hope we can get through a lot of it, though, because I'm not gonna lie, this one is a lot of backtracky kind of stuff. But it's really pretty.
So distracted by that badge that's right at the top of the screen.
Just don't think about it.
Look at his little legs.
I love peonies. They're so cute. This way, he says, as he walks towards a crack in the wall that you can't get through.
Yeah. I snuck up on him. Oh, a secret entrance. Mm-hmm.
How cool is that?
Sick. Puny is what they're called?
Puny. P-U-N-I.
It's cute.
I love punies.
It's a cool looking pipe. It's like a wooden pipe. A black and white wooden pipe. Oh, the puny guy is black and white too, I'm noticing.
Yeah, I like the Bogby wisdom, so excited.
Oh shit! The door he opens. Apparently there's something hidden back there.
Oh, dang. I didn't even know about that. I'm excited because I'm learning stuff that, like, I haven't done before.
The Great Bogley Tree. Tobias Paulson says, "Hey Nick, has Nintendo taken down any of your videos?" No. Not to my knowledge.
Bogley Woods. So pretty.
Wow.
Boggling.
Boggling.
Oh, I've never heard Goombello talk about the Bogley Woods, because they usually have coops.
Do the coops also say that they're boggling?
Yeah, I think... I don't remember what coop says.
Oh, shit! I could have gotten that badge if I had gone left.
We can go back.
I like how many people there are in the chat who,
have played it?
Yeah, like, yeah. Know it, like, backwards and forwards, just like you do.
I feel like they know a little bit more than me, or, like, about different things.
Yeah, like, you maybe know more lore stuff, but they know where a lot of the secrets are. Alright, let's do it. So
Whoa.
I love stuff like this. Oh yeah, I should have known, because the wall's the same.
It's okay.
Actually, I don't think that wall had flipped yet when I saw it.
It didn't.
Yeah.
Decrease damage by one with a guard action command. That's really nice. That is a really good badge.
So, like, one additional damage?
So, like, when something attacks you, you get basically, like, one defense. Right?
When I do a guard action command, so, like, when I hit A, right?
Yeah, so when you block, you know, sometimes you still take one damage?
Yeah.
You wouldn't.
This would do one additional block damage, basically.
Mm-hmm.
That's tight. So I'm gonna go multi-bounce, damage dodge.
Nice.
I got 9 badges this early in the game. How tight is that? That I'm wearing.
That's really cool.
4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Yeah. Unless I'm counting wrong. God, this level looks awesome. What's this called? Boggy Woods?
Boggy Woods, yeah.
Alrighty. Well, actually, before, because we've been going for about an hour now, I want to take a break and, like, make some coffee.
Sounds good.
You want to take a break real quick?
Yeah, I want to eat a little bit.
Alrighty. We're going to have a food and coffee break. We'll be back in, like, some amount of minutes. So, yeah, we'll be
back.
It's
a good description of time.
I gotta click. Where's the BRB thing? I gotta move that somewhere. Anyways, we'll be back soon. Goodbye.
I like your little BRB screen.
Thank you. I had to type that in because nobody knew what it meant. Thank you.
going back on the charger.
Alrighty, here we go. Mm-hmm. We're back.
I can hold this for you.
I wanted, honestly, poor Mario fell asleep. Oops, I honestly, sorry. You gotta charge it?
Yep.
I got you. I honestly kind of wanted to stream the quesadilla making process, but I thought about it and like tried to figure out in my mind if there was an easy way to do it, and there wasn't. Maybe if I got like a super long USB cable, but we're back!
Oh my god.
Is it good?
Yeah.
Crazy. Let's get...
Primer.
Hold on, will it autofocus?
Mm-hmm.
Is my camera set up to autofocus right? Yes, it is. Okay.
Yeah? Here. Just hold that up. Like.
Look at this. This is gonna be my piece now. Look at that! It's like a fucking string cheese commercial. Better. I'm gonna eat it. I'm not gonna... I touched it already, so I'm not gonna make you.
I don't care, but also...
I'm like sick, dude. Did you put sour cream in it?
Yeah.
Nice.
Did you not?
No, I'm down. You put it in the quesadilla?
Yeah. No, I didn't. I just dipped it. I just intensely dipped it.
Pixelon had the idea of having my friend Michael Head do Twitch Plays quesadillas, where the Twitch chat makes the quesadilla. So every time someone says L9, it puts 9 squirts of sour cream on it.
Oh my god.
That would be great.
That would be nice.
Chaz Hayward said, good to see that Andrea got the hang of peeling string cheese. After you were like... very shamed.
I had to learn. I didn't know.
You spent the past week practicing?
Yeah, I did, actually.
You would, like, try and just be, damn it, no, it didn't work, and throw it away.
Yeah.
Whatever.
Mm-hmm. Totally. How'd you know?
Ugh. Alrighty.
God, it's amazing. Eat some before I eat it all.
Of the quesadilla?
Mm-hmm.
I think you're hungrier than me. We've had both a donut today and some quesadilla. Always good to eat chips on microphone. All right.
No, I'm sure.
Tell me where we are.
So this is the Bogley Woods. You could also ask Goombella.
All right. Sorry, Goombella. Tell me where we are. These are the Bogley Woods. It's like out of a picture book. Agreed. Was that ding you or me? That was you.
Mm-hmm.
I'm gonna mute your phone if that's okay.
Is that a link to me devouring string cheese wrong?
Oh my god, I hope so.
Goodness.
Alrighty. For some reason, the internet was being janky for a second, so I was like, wait out.
No redemption on twitch.tv.
We don't really forgive in these parts. That little bug dude's following me, that's nice. I'm gonna eat this one that's just been like soaking in the sour cream for a while.
Such a good idea.
Dude, papalote salsa, man.
This is my favorite little... I don't know, I say that about every song, but I really like the Shadow Sirens theme. Like, if I had a theme song, I think it'd be this.
I'm talking about murder.
Mm-hmm.
Don't the X-Nauts, like, want to make sure that no harm comes to... Well, they only care about Peach, I guess.
Yeah. Amnesia says, this game has amazing music, Andrea. I agree. It's my favorite. I know all of them are good, but I really like this one.
You can set this down on, like, our legs if you want.
Well, because they don't match up because I have shorter legs.
And I also sit on my own feet all the time.
Okay.
But I just felt bad that you had to, like, hold it.
I didn't mind.
A super heavy plate.
I felt like a... Oh my god. It's fine. You're actually playing, though. So, like, it's not a big deal.
I feel like that witch on the right is definitely Waluigi. Wearing a hat.
Actually, maybe.
Oh, I want to see the sketch of Mario. Hey. Yeah, draw your own sketch. Gah. Does she speak? The one in the middle?
Hmm. She just makes noises.
I like her bangs.
I love the shadow sirens.
The what?
The shadow sirens. That's what they're called.
Shadow sirens. Aww. Beldum. Like Bedlam, but different slightly.
Mm-hmm.
What a rude lady.
It's one more quesadilla piece. It's all yours.
Are you sure?
Mm-hmm. I won't eat it.
The strong silent type. I can't get a good read on this girl at all. Oh, none of them know what I look like. Well, she should. The one of them left, because she has a sketch, yeah. Oh, she's too bummed out to even look at me. Wow, look at those petals. This should be called Petalburg. Whoa. Oh.
Yeah, what would you call just the little enemies and things on the way.
Are you talking about that specific thing?
No, all the enemies in this level, I think, are pretty...
Like the random encounters?
Yeah. Not hard, they're just... This game is pretty. God, Pablo de Salsa is amazing.
It's so good. I should, see if I can get a sponsorship.
Pablo de?
From Pablo de Salsa.
You should.
Hiders.
Mm-hmm.
What's this? Okay. Oh, look, he's following me in the background. Or no, maybe he wasn't. Maybe he was just going. I feel like this area is really big and I haven't, really explored it much.
Oh, you will.
The way the sky looks, it's all dotted.
I love this tree.
The great tree. Does it talk?
Electrium says, I got Pablo de Salsa shipped to Wisconsin because that's necessary.
Wow. That's awesome. Yeah, that's commitment.
Asriel says to get a string cheese sponsor.
That would be a good idea, too. But, the problem with that is that I don't like any brand name string cheese. I just like the shitty store-bought ones, so if I did it, I wouldn't feel authentic, you know?
You could start your own string cheese chain.
Yeah, where I just take, the grocery store brand and repackage it.
Yeah. You could throw it in, a Ziploc.
Sort of like a lemonade stand, but for string cheese.
Yeah. Actually, yeah, that's a good idea.
What would be a reasonable price?
How much would you pay for string cheese? I'd just start my day maybe 50 cents.
Wonder if that would be profitable.
Probably not.
Yeah. I bet we could probably get away with a dollar.
I don't know if I'd pay a dollar for string cheese.
In this city, though, people would probably do it.
Oh, yeah. Trendy things.
Secret entrance. I don't know, but we should find it.
God, I never mixed it with sour cream before. That's amazing.
True.
Can we just do a stream where we just eat
chips? Right now, Twitch has expanded from just games to music. We have to wait until they expand to... What are those, Korean videos that are just people eating? You know about that? It's a thing.
There's models that eat.
Yeah.
And you pay to watch them eat.
That could be us.
I'd be down. I Actually, Sea King's right. You buy it in bulk from the store, you pay less overall, and then you sell it.
I actually am already almost doing that. I'm buying the largest string cheese packages they'll sell me. They're like the 32 packs. We go through a lot of S cheese in this house, as we call it.
I don't think I've eaten string cheese since I was like 12 until like I started coming here for this stream.
It's just so convenient. It's the perfect snack.
I like popcorn.
I like popcorn too.
Popcorn's a really good snack.
Right, we're gonna find this elegant lady to blow something away or something.
Well, $100 watched some of those eating videos. So we already have a fan base.
Someone in the chat pointed out this secret badge to me, so. Mm. Holy crap, it's like a free level up.
Mm-hmm.
Wowzer. I thought she said Bowser when I fast-forwarded through it the first time.
Wowzer.
So long, gay Wowzer.
Did I text you that recently, or was it someone else?
It wasn't me, but I wish it was. That's how I'm going to end every conversation with you. So long, gay Bowser.
Actually, yeah, that's fine.
It's perfect.
Maurice343 says, Nick, there's a stream where you watch the streamer sleep.
Should I get into that business?
Yeah.
Just get someone to automatically run a commercial every 8 minutes? Make money while I sleep.
That's pretty cool.
She's saying the tree's over 1,000 years old.
Oh, man.
That is an old tree. So, we gotta find this gusty lady.
Men and Flurry.
Look at the sky. It looks like what are they, the witches in Madoka?
Oh, yeah. That does not look like one of those.
Oh, this coffee's good. It pairs nicely with the quesadillas.
And the Coke.
And the Coke. There's yours, by the way. The little blue one.
Oh, cute. Thank you.
Tastes like coffee ice cream, kind of.
This is actually really good. It does pair well.
Feel the need for drama. I like whoever this is. I like how many hearts she's using. Make my beauty even more beautiful.
I feel like that could be Andy's, like, tagline somewhere.
Change his avatar on Twitter to her?
No. But maybe just like his little bio.
Current. Oops. Do I lose health for that? Yeah. Andy's current tagline is, I'm too glamorous to tweet for myself, which is a real quote from him.
I love that.
Wait, did I go to the house? You know, I gotta find the house. Alrighty. I like that he's giving me some direction at least.
Yeah, I really like. I like this little puzzle. I'm gonna let you do it.
I feel bad that this. I'm gonna like make it so this computer stops falling asleep so the YouTube chat doesn't get ignored.
I feel bad because it's hard for me to look over at it.
Yeah.
But I'll start.
I can be the YouTube chat if you'd like.
Okay.
Energy saver. Set it all to bad. Turn display off, never.
Never.
There we go.
It's gonna tell you, oh, you sure you wanna do that?
Wow,
it's gonna drain your battery down.
The YouTube chat is insisting that they would buy Nick Robinson branded string cheese.
Awesome. Wow.
We're halfway there. We've got an audience. Wow, that cloud is cute.
Mm-hmm. Oh god, I just noticed something about the cloud. Are those eyes or eyebrows? I always assumed they were eyebrows.
Oh, I saw it as like closed eyes with like eyeshadow.
Oh.
Maybe you're right. Maybe it's angry eyebrows. I was thinking it as like a cute girl with her eyes closed. Like she's smiling and she's. Let's find out. Let's see if we can get any hints.
Okay, those. I can't tell if it's smiling.
He looks, even if it's eyebrows, he looks like a kindly old grandpa to me.
Yeah, but if it's eyes, he looks like maybe a ghost boy. Like Casper.
He doesn't look mean. He's smiling.
Everyone says they're eyes, but they look like eyebrows to me.
Yeah, I see them as eyelids. Like closed eyes. But...
wow, other people can't even see the eyebrows. I can't not see them.
Oh, it looks very... maybe they are eyes. Alright, can't touch him. If I hit him with my hammer, would that zap me?
No.
Alright. Oh shit, fuck! I always forget that that's an action prompt. I, like, looked away. Alright.
Okay, so everyone else sees them the right way.
By the right way, you mean Andrea's way, right?
No, I mean the way I'm not seeing it, because I'm clearly wrong. Nice.
That's like an attack worth doing now.
Mm-hmm. You need to start doing stylish points.
CNN Albrecht says, guys, what do you think about Smash Bros. 3DS? Is it as bad as everyone says? I just played it today and thought it was amazing, but I'm new to the franchise. I really like it.
I think it's fun.
It's like, you should, if you, like, the Wii U one is kind of, I think, clearly the version to get if you can.
Mm-hmm.
But, it's totally serviceable. I can't believe that game works at all. I thought it was going to be horrible.
I think the biggest complaints I've heard about it are just, problems with the stick.
Look at this. She's giving, specific advice for this.
Whoa. I never tried to do that? That's crazy.
Go in plain mode. And then she's also can also look at the crack on the right. I don't see what she's talking about yet, but... no! Well...
nice.
She told me what to do. Umbella gets all the credit for that.
Well, I'm gonna pretend that...
puzzle solved.
Okay.
She is smart. That's why I love her. Have you ever played Rhythm Heaven?
You asked me this before.
Really?
And I said a little bit with my cousins, and then you had me play Rhythm Heaven. And I played the Easter Island Head one.
So the one that you had played before, was that the Wii
I think
one?
It's the same one.
Oh, the 3DS one?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Whoa, hold on, sorry.
But I never owned it.
Look at that shine box over there. Ooh, wait, hold on. I'm gonna try something.
You definitely should do what I think you're doing. Yeah.
Oh, I missed.
Power says Goombella is so much smarter than Nick.
True. And cuter. Alrighty. Puzzle solved. You like that?
Very close.
Like
very
that?
Close. Ooh, I love Quake Hammer.
What's the Quake ability that I got from that star also? Isn't that supposed to be a thing?
Oh yeah, Earth Tremor.
How do I use that?
That's my favorite one. Sorry, I wasn't thinking about it.
Look at that. He's slowly inching his way around the pole. He's gonna get me.
I still see eyebrows.
Barely escaped that.
Wayne's asking if this is my favorite game. I think so. I'm pretty sure this is my favorite game.
What are some of your others?
Goodness, Rayman.
Is there a specific Rayman?
Actually, yes, which is weird. Rayman 3 is my favorite Rayman. I love the new Raymans, and they're a lot different, though.
Rayman 3 was 3D, right? Like, polygonal?
Mm-hmm. It was, actually.
Do you have a subtitle?
A subtitle?
Yeah, it's called, there was Rayman...
Hoodlum Havoc.
Hoodlum Havoc, okay.
Yeah. So I really like Rayman 3. Gosh. I mean, obviously, I'm a huge Kingdom Hearts fan. I like the second one, and I really like the first one. Yes, that is Andrea Pope's my new thing.
Nice joke.
That someone just asked. But, I really like... oh, Kid Icarus Uprising is really fun.
For right-handed people?
Yeah, Nick's left-handed, so he doesn't...
So, I'm currently trying to get used to playing that game with the new 3DS using... the C-stick to move around, which you can do. But there's no way to... My instinct was that there was going to be a way to play it, so like I used the circle pad for movement and then the C-stick for camera movement. They don't let you do that. I had to like Google it too. I was like, because the 3DS C-stick just acts like circle pad pro.
Really?
It's like that's what the 3DS thinks it is. So like, I don't know. It's just fun. And everyone was like, "What?" Like even back in the circle pad pro days, people were like, "Why can't I use the circle pad pro to move the camera and then use the other stick to move around like every other first person shooter in existence?" And everyone was like, "Cause it's Sakurai's game. He can do what he wants. Don't question him." And I was like, "All right, internet."
Every one of Sakurai's decisions.
Wow. Sapiental Madness says that Snake Eater on 3DS was 20 FPS and such a bummer. Yeah, I didn't play that. That Dang. I don't like MGS3 as much as most people. I'm sorry. I like it, but Metal Gear Solid 2 is my favorite.
I've never really played any of the Metal Gear Solid games. The beginning of Guns of the Patriots. And I just didn't...
Me neither. I played the first chapter of Guns of the Patriots, and I just was not compelled to keep moving. I don't know why.
I felt like it was because I wasn't, like, I didn't know anything about the series.
It's so funny, though, because as someone who had played all the games and loved them all, I still got to that game should have been perfect for me, and I got to it, and I was just like, I feel like I'm playing this wrong. Like, they changed the controls a lot.
Mm-hmm.
It became, like, kind of a more, like, a traditional action game, and it made it really confusing to play for me as, like, a Metal Gear fan.
Getcha. I getcha. Also, actually, I'm a huge Gears of War fan, which is...
Really?
Yeah, actually, yeah. I have the collector's edition that comes with the little flag, and I hang it in my window. And, actually, in the bathroom at work, there's a giant Marcus Fenix poster from Gears of War 2, and it's, like, from 2008, even. And it's just on the door. So whenever I have to go to the bathroom at work, I tell my boss, like, oh, I have to go hang out with Marcus for a little bit, and then he hands me the
keys.
That's
cute. Me and Marcus.
Me and Marcus. I got in a fight with someone at work. Well, not a fight. I got in... a tiny argument with the customer because they said they couldn't get attached to any of the characters in Gears of War because they were all dumb meatheads with no substance. And I was like, ouch!
I mean, my understanding is that Gears 3 actually gets pretty real.
Gears 2 gets pretty real, too. I don't want to spoil it for people that haven't played it, but,
Maybe we could stream Gears someday.
I love Gears.
That'd be so tight.
I get to be Marcus, though.
Deal.
Yay. I have all the gears. Also Halo 2.
God, wait, how have we never talked about this?
I didn't know you liked Halo 2.
Dude, Halo 2 is amazing.
It's my favorite one.
But, like, for me, though, it's the multiplayer. Like, that's the part that I'm passionate about.
I'm passionate about the Arbiter, and I'm passionate about being able to control the Covenant, and finally using the Arbiter's L1. So you can actually, like, go invisible for a while and do, like, stealth missions.
I should
missions.
Introduce you to a friend of mine who is obsessed with the Arbiter equally.
The Arbiter was my icon for a while, and people were just like, why do you have a weird dinosaur as your icon? I just changed it. It just wasn't worth it.
A weird dinosaur. Oh, because she doesn't have her makeup? Oh, is it the necklace? Yeah. Yeah, mm-hmm. It is. Yeah, I see what you mean about this being backtracky.
Yeah. Although it doesn't seem that bad because you're not, like, running into a ton of stuff.
Yeah, I've managed to luck out and, like, avoid a lot of enemies so far. G. Alexander says, please stream Gears.
Better saying Halo 2.
I've started looking into alternative options to streaming with the Elgato because it's, like, you saw what happened when we tried to do WarioWare.
Yes.
It was rough. Yeah. So, I'm going to put some effort. I put a lot of effort into trying to fix that. I'll put some effort into continuing with that, but I'm also going to put effort into just, like, trying to get a capture card that is real-time, that doesn't have that problem. And then we can start doing console games. I just want her with me all the time.
Goombella?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Not even in this game, just in life.
Yeah, I think about that sometimes, too.
Imagine if you could just press X at, like, the grocery store and have her tell you about
people.
It. And about people.
Like, just walk into, like, this old lady, and she's like, she used to be the wife of, like, mafioso.
Yeah.
Is mafiosos? Oh, Afropower still votes for Barkley. Shut Up and Jam Gaiden.
Do you want to do that?
I'd also be down for Shut Up and Jam Gaiden.
Can we just stream games every Wednesday until, like, we die?
Yeah.
Cool.
I will do my best. Until I move in the summer. It's gonna be hard to get down here.
Oh, are you moving?
Santa Cruz.
Oh shit, really?
Yeah.
Holy shit. Well, we have to stream all these games before the summer.
That's gonna be impossible. It's gonna be really hard.
Word is he's super. Yeah, I'm Super Mario. Nope, can't do it. Sorry. PlayStation.
Oh, you know what else is a really fun game, but I don't even know how we would stream it?
Huh.
Did you ever play, like, on Xbox, like, the original Xbox? Did you play, Munch's Odyssey?
No. Wait, yes.
Or Abe's
that was
Odyssey.
A launch game on the mm-hmm. on the original Xbox, yeah.
I really liked it. It was really funny.
Who was just talking to me about that game?
I think they're either redoing or they're doing a new, like, Abe's Odyssey. And I keep seeing ads for it, but I haven't looked into it, which I should have.
Someone was telling me last night, I think, about, like, one time they were playing that game, and they accidentally, like, farted, and this guard got killed, and she thinks about it all the time, like, every day. Is that Victoria? Might have been Victoria telling that story.
That's so funny. If so, I need to talk to her about Munch's Odyssey. It sounds like Munch's. Well, actually, it sounds like Abe, because Abe farts and Munch burps.
Mm.
But when I say, this is a specific way I say, like, when I say everybody, I go, like, everybody. And I'm saying it, like, that's how Munch did, and he would call these little things. It's, like, this dumb thing I still do. From a game no one cares about anymore.
They're still fighting, huh? You twit.
So Master is asking if that was the Mountain Dew game, and I remember you drinking a lot of sodas, so I think maybe that might be what you're talking about.
I remember the ad, and I think maybe cover art for Munch's Odyssey was, like, a soda can, like a soda machine or something.
Yeah, no, you drink a lot of sodas in that. Also, someone just brought up Blinks the Time Sweeper. I'm really surprised that someone remembers Blinks the Time Sweeper.
There was two of those. There was a Blinks 2.
I know. I played Blinks 2. I liked them. I thought they were really cute and fun.
It was so cool, like, to pause time and then walk through a river and just, like, leave a trail behind you of
yes.
all the water that you push out of the way.
God, Blinks was so cool. Did I ask you about Voodoo Vince yet?
Have we?
There's a game I played called Voodoo Vince, and no one remembers it, and I thought I, like, imagined it.
We've definitely made Voodoo Vince jokes on one of the podcasts I do, Pod Burglars. We like to joke about, like, irrelevant, like, second-rate platformers that nobody played.
Oh, and I played Voodoo Vince.
Yeah. There was an era where, like, there were so many, like, GameCube and Xbox and PS2 era, like, platformers of that style. There were so many.
There were.
I want everyone in the chat to name as many, like, obscure, like, kind of semi-shitty platformers.
Attack of the Power 2-2. Just kidding. That was a 3D
Tack.
Adventure.
That was when I knew we were going to be friends, is when we were making Tack jokes.
I found Tack the other day at, like, this retro game store when I bought Billy Hatcher, actually.
Did you know that 2 is just called Tack 2? It's not like Tack and the Power of Juju.
I thought it was Dreams.
Yeah, Tack and Dreams. But it's not like Tack and the Power of Juju 2.
Yeah, I know. It's called... I think it's... Because there's not really any Juju. It ended up being about stupid... Jabulba's brother's dreams, and that game sucked.
Tack 2?
Yeah.
Adam Collier says, "I know Nick left-handed problems. How do you feel about spiral notebooks? They're the worst. You're grinding your hand against them. This world is not made for our kind."
That's how I feel, except about being a woman.
Yeah, I guess that's a little worse. Like, at least. The world is passively shitty for left-handed people. The world is actively shitty for women.
People are naming those games that you wanted. Croc. Oh, also Tasmanian Tiger. Without warning...
Space Station Silicon Valley, I have not thought about. That was so, seeing that name stunned me into getting a random encounter. Buck Bumble also is great. I'm going to make you listen to the theme song to Buck Bumble if you haven't heard it.
I think I have. I'm positive. I've heard of Buck Bumble. For sure.
I'd get a copyright strike for doing the Buck Bumble song on here.
That'd be fun. I don't think anyone will be. Oh, Bubsy.
Wait, she can do multi-bonk? Or, like, she can do a multi...
Yeah, sure it was.
Alright, I don't want to touch him.
Banjo-Kazooie. I feel like Banjo-Kazooie doesn't really count.
No, it's too good. And too,
yeah.
Like, too critically acclaimed and,
mm-hmm.
I want, like, obscure shit. Alright, True Fan says Croc. Twinbee for GBA. Was Twinbee a platformer, though? Or was it like a scrolling shooter? I don't know
what Twinbee is.
Sorry.
And I feel really bad about it.
Look at her. Bubsy, dude.
I mentioned Bubsy. I said Bubsy, and you made me, he made like me watch him play Bubsy's back the other day.
Nope.
Oh, check this out.
So it's a positive curse.
Mm-hmm. It's gonna help.
Fuck,
you.
That's a lot of damage. Yeah. I kind of wish that had happened in like a more serious battle. Yeah, Bubsy 3D is amazing. Yeah, dude, I played and owned both Bubsy games. I'm a big Bubsy 2 apologist. The game was kind of open world.
I haven't played Bubsy 2, but I played Bubsy on SNES.
What could possibly go wrong? He says at the beginning of the first level, which is called...
Oh, yeah! And he would say it in like, this really obnoxious voice, like, what could possibly go
sounded
wrong?
Sounded horrible on the Genesis version. yeah, that game was weird, because, like... Oh, I can't do it. The first level in that game is called Cheese Wheels of Doom, just to give you a sense of like
that what, sounds familiar.
What game developer humor was like.
I used to get really stuck in the... Did you play the SNES one?
No, I played the Genesis one, but I think they were pretty similar.
Yeah, let's see. There was a carnival level, and you have to run down the roller coaster.
That sounds really familiar to me.
Right? And it's like nighttime and all the... I don't know why I got so stuck on stupid Bubsy. I didn't even like Bubsy. I don't even know why I played it. I'm getting mad now.
The game is like the worst vibe in the world.
It does,
it's so
right?
horrible.
I don't know why I hate it. I'm just gonna keep listing other games now because I feel like we haven't talked about games that much.
Star Yoshi says, I thought you were going to play Punch-Out. That was yesterday, but I couldn't get this streaming to work, basically. Yeah, I spent a lot of time yesterday trying to get my Elgato to cooperate with me, and it just kept getting worse and worse. And I was like, you know what? I'll just play stuff on Steam.
I got pictures.
Yeah.
TrueFan1980 is talking about Genesis Aladdin, and Aladdin is really fun. Have you played Aladdin?
No, but I think I mentioned this on another stream, but I don't think you were there. there's a... really cool video series that Double Fine is doing right now, where they have game developers play their favorite games and kind of talk about them, kind of like
so
these
cool.
super long Let's Plays.
Mm-hmm.
And for the episode on Aladdin / The Lion King, they had, it's Greg Rice doing the Let's Play, but they had one of the developers of The Lion King game come in and tell the story of like how that game was made and how that game seemed really similar to Aladdin to a lot of people, but they actually, the company shut down, and so they had to like rebuild the engine from scratch to make it feel like Aladdin.
What?
And how the animation was like actually done by Disney, but they, the artists internally had to like basically take the Disney animations and like redraw them as pixel art, which was really, really hard. Oh, there's something in the crowd.
Oh no, that was a good item.
Oh, I hit it because I was like trying to grab it, but that's not how that works.
It's okay. Psychonauts. Sorry,
Psychonauts is too good to be considered for the list.
No, Electrium said the Double Fine show Psychonauts speedrun was hilarious.
I haven't watched that yet. I should do that.
I was just at a retro gaming store and they had Raz like on a. They had like all of these like older game characters and that's actually how I realized I didn't make up Voodoo Vince because Voodoo Vince was on there next to Blinks and I was like, what?
Were they plushy? What are you saying?
It was like a poster of like all these retro games and they were standing in front of their old consoles.
That's weird.
It was cool. That's
why would you put Voodoo Vince on there?
Because Voodoo Vince is cool.
Adam Koye says, Tack is amazing. Croc, Raystar.
God, what even?
I don't know what Raystar is.
Wow, did I just get called a new tasty morsel? That's a good thing to be called. I like that.
Are you sure?
No, I don't like that. That's really creepy.
The colorless subspecies is adapted to boggly woods. So basically what happened was a piranha plant seed was brought to the boggly woods and then like it just evolved in nature into a black and white version. So it's like camouflage so it can like jump out and eat stuff.
I love that.
I love the world building that they're doing here. Uh-oh. What if I... Can I use the mask?
Yeah, actually, yeah. Let's do it. I love the mask. I like how the fright mask is Bowser. Oh,
yeah.
It didn't work.
Even piranha plants are apparently scared of Bowser. Oh, I should have used it with Goombella.
Half of Power is saying we need more homeless people in the chat because homeless people target me.
Apparently. Can't head bonk. I'm not really in danger. I have 5 health.
Actually, I kind of remember something about a Pink Panther platformer. I want to say I know I haven't played it though. I want to say I wouldn't waste it.
Yeah, it's not worth it right now, but I just found
it. You need to play it. I love Earthdrummer. It's my favorite. I don't know why. I like Art Attack. It's cool, but
sweet.
Also the Sly Cooper series. Just throwing out Sly Cooper because I love it. I have all three. I finally found two, and that's hard. Have you played this?
Did I just get thrown into another battle when I looked away?
Mm-hmm.
I'm leaving.
Oh, you could try your Earthdrummer battle.
Oh, I could do that too.
That's okay.
I just got the Sly Cooper for the Vita because it was on sale for like
Thieves in Time.
Yeah, the new
or
one.
The collection. Okay, Thieves in Time.
Some of the Koopas are like turning around to look back at the camera and like wiggling left and right.
Oh, it's so cute, isn't it? Oh, what about Gunslinger says Sweet Treat.
Maybe.
Oh, did you? Yes, I'm excited to use Earth Tremor. I love it. So it's... You're gonna like it, because it's kind of like a rhythm head of my
Donkey Konga.
Dude, oh, we should play Donkey Konga. I can bring my Kongas.
Yes.
I have two. Official Pixelon says, how about Booger Man?
I never played it, but there was an ad for it on like the back of one of my manuals or something.
I love Sly. Other people talk about Sly, and I'm just thinking how much I love Sly. Sly 2 is really hard. Like, Sly 3 was hard? Oh god, that's so cute. And Sly... Ooh, close ball worked.
Yay. Do you... What's up with, like, the whole theater theme of this game?
Because
it's not really present in Paper Mario, I don't think.
Yeah, no.
By this degree.
Don't know. Rock Lobster is a good song on Donkey Konga.
Hell yeah.
My favorite is I really like doing.
Boom, boom, boom. I remember it. I remember the whole step.
Did you have to? You did have to clap.
Yeah.
I really liked doing all the small things because you would do the. I don't know why I remember that. I liked Whip It and all the small things.
They were all like covers too.
Yeah, they were bad too.
Hey, we just got a power block.
Nice.
Let's use it.
God, that'd be so funny if I brought Kongas. I went on a really long Twitter rant one time at like 2 a.m. about how we should be able to play the new Smash. Like, I was saying that like my excuse when I lose at Smash from now on is going to be that I don't have a Konga. And like, I could beat you if I had my Donkey Kongas, because that's the only way I can play Smash well. But like, what if Smash was Konga compatible?
I wish.
And you took it to like tournaments and you just showed up with a Konga.
That would be so tight.
With your special controller, and then you just sit there and you're Konga-ing.
I wonder if it could be done. I wonder like what kind of type of modifications we'd have to do to make that possible.
I think it'd be great. Either way, I think it'd be really funny. Like, you'd be a dark horse. No one would expect this. Right. You know, what are you doing? They can't tell because you're using a Konga.
Have you, I'm gonna use a mushroom. Have you, well, there's no way, I'm sure I've asked this before, I'm sorry. Have you played Donkey Kong Jungle Beat?
No, wasn't that the game that's like an actual
platformer
game? Yeah,
that
an
you
actual
play with
platformer
the
that you use with the Konga.
So, fun fact about that game was the first game from the group at Nintendo, Nintendo EAD Tokyo, who went on to make Mario Galaxy, Mario Galaxy 2, Super Mario 3D Land, Super Mario 3D World, and Captain Toad, some of the best Mario games ever. They also made Jungle Beat, and that's why Jungle Beat is incredible.
I did not know that about Jungle Beat. How do I get that?
So they actually put out a Wii version of it that changed the controls to make it more like a traditional platformer.
Cool.
I never played it because I always assumed that what it did was they just remapped the Konga controls to like a remote and nunchuck and you'd have to drum like this, which sounded horrible.
Yeah.
But that's not actually what they did, apparently. Apparently it just makes it into a normal video game.
Oh, okay. I still want to try it.
Yeah. By the way, I've got Tropical Freeze like over there.
Yeah!
In my bed.
Yeah, I need to actually play that because I want to and I'm jealous of you.
I haven't played it yet either. I'm saving it for you.
Yes! I'm so excited. Welch 2008 a while ago said, Ratchet & Clank movie and Sly Cooper movie. And of course, Uncharted eventually. I have to say though, like, why make an Uncharted movie? Uncharted's already a movie.
Yeah, Uncharted 2 is the best Uncharted movie there will ever be. Nathan Drake is perfectly cast as Nathan Drake.
Like, I don't know. I'm not a huge fan of games that play like movies.
Oh, I love so much.
For it, but it's fine. You know, I'm not gonna. I just can't do it.
I feel you. The Three Shadow Beauties.
Yeah.
Wow. Plug ugly?
Wow.
I've never... What does that mean?
We should look it up. Is now a good time to talk about the Vivian stuff? Or
she's being mean to, like, the...
Yeah.
Can I, like... I don't want to ask.
What?
I don't want to spoil anything. But...
Night Eater 1 just suggested Smash Bros. With Guitar Hero peripherals. That would also be good.
Yeah, you could do that.
Like, what if you had, like, the top Donkey Konga Smash player go up against the top Guitar Hero player?
So, basically have Donkey Kong versus Shulk.
Simon Damon says Nick's not ready for the Vivian stuff, so I'll hold off on it. But, oh, wow, Soul Calibur, you played it with a Guitar Hero controller? That's...
There's a with a Guitar Hero controller.
That's awesome.
Did string cheese just fall out of my pocket?
Where did that even come from?
Are we really gonna fight?
God, their fight music is adorable. I know I keep talking about the soundtrack, but look, it's great.
The soundtrack's awesome, though. It's like melted too much.
I'm like tempted the week that we actually get to do more with them and go into Twilight Town to actually bring my Duplis, like, background.
Outfit? Oh.
My giant, like, Duplis mural.
Right.
I might bring it. That'd be funny. I'll even, like, attach it so it can just be, like, behind us.
That would be nice.
Yeah, it'd be really funny.
It's so... Look how limp it is. It's got too warm.
That's really gross. I was gonna ask for some, but I don't want it now.
You haven't had enough string cheese today?
No. Pocket cheese is Nick meme now. Exploding Alien says, I was at a talk by Richard Bartle, the main developer of the first MUD, where he was explaining why you can't really convert one medium of art into another by the very nature. You can't convert the essence, especially in an interactive medium like a game.
Yeah, so like that's why all video game movies are terrible and vice versa?
I guess.
It's an interesting theory.
That is. What about the, Spider-Man 2?
True. I nailed it.
God, do you ever just think about how great Spider-Man 2 was?
Yeah.
Love Spider-Man 2.
That game was real good. The pizza theme was pretty good in Spider-Man 3, though.
No.
Just the song that plays. Hold on. Spider-Man pizza music. I'm looking it up. No, it's from Spider-Man 2, sorry. You know the pizza delivery in Spider-Man 2?
Mm-hmm.
Muting the game. So we can listen to this.
I played this game.
I did too. Spider-Man 2 was awesome. It was a really good open world game with really good swinging physics.
Yes.
But also this song.
Racing. BBNZ just shut up and says, have I come in at a weird time? A little bit.
So, what a nice sounding song.
It is. God, I'm getting stressed.
We're running out of time.
In a good way.
Sounds great.
Look at all the instrumentals in this track. Look at how cute. You just don't, like, You just did a little taunt thing.
Yeah, I don't think I'd actually seen Mario's appeal before that. Anyways.
Oh, yeah, you have, because it was dumb, and you were like, wow, I'm never...
Oh, he just waves hello?
Yeah, he just...
I mean, compared to Goombellas, like, they're all...
I think Koopsis is really cute.
Chaz Hay says it's a song from VeggieTales. Yeah, my fine silk hat.
Oh my god.
I bet that others wish they had, in fact, a hat so fine. I had, like, mine, a fine silk hat.
That's the one VeggieTales song I don't know.
Like, I know. I had the Silly Songs with Larry, like, CD. I would listen to it as I fell asleep every night.
Do you remember Where Is My Hairbrush and...
Oh, where? Yeah.
I used to have the Pirates Who Don't Do Anything as my ringtone. In high school, like, that's...
Hell yeah. Silly Songs with Larry should have been its own series. Its own, like, sort of, what's the word? Oh, I blocked that? It still did 4 damage, huh?
You're tiny.
I wanted, like, a secular spin-off of VeggieTales that was just Silly Songs with Larry. That would have been tight. Just goofs. I want an Earth Tremor, but I don't even know if it would hit them, because they're ghosts. Do you think it would?
Yeah, it will.
Well, I'm doing this anyway, because I need flower points, because I want to hit them with shells.
Yeah.
Oof. Every time I fire one.
Sweet Treat always lags for some reason.
Yeah. Look at all these sweet treats I'm getting. I like it when it slows down. It makes it easier for me. I'm just trying to get these FPs.
PB&Z says, I saw this one episode of VeggieTales where they were like, could we do this if we had arms? And they just all stared at each other in silence for 15 seconds.
Damn. Realness.
Yeah.
What status effect does she have? She's like big?
Yes.
Alright.
I think that just means her attack power is higher.
Gotcha. Alrighty. Now I have enough flower points to hit him with the power shell.
Nice.
Aw, rip. What you gonna do now?
Dang.
Eek.
It's really hard to guard those magic attacks.
Yeah, because there's not really any clear visual indicator of like when it's actually technically gonna hit.
Mm-hmm.
Actually, yeah, I'll do it.
Ooh, Power Smash. I like how powerful Power Smash feels.
Yes.
Oh, also, what time is it? Okay, 2:20. I'm supposed to be back by like 4:30, so I can leave around 3:15.
Wait, what time is it now?
2:20.
2:20.
So we have some time.
Like, first time I've ever screwed it up. Yeah, the timing was weird.
That's awesome.
Wow! Holy crap.
That's so cool.
So I'm gonna level.
Yeah. Dang, dude.
That's amazing.
Are you glad you got cursed now?
I am. So, flower points?
Yeah, TrueFan1980 says you gotta start styling these moves up. I agree. We have to start working on Nick's style points. By the end of the day, that's my goal, is to get your style
today?
Points. Yes.
Alright.
I'm gonna start getting your style points up.
We got the nickels, though.
That's true. You and Koops did just go, like, attack a bunch of, like, girls.
Well,
I'm just kidding.
They stole the nickels. Ooh, look at that honey. How am I doing, actually, on stats right now? Well, I'm full.
Yeah, because you leveled up.
Oh, right, right. Mm-hmm. Alrighty. Actually, let me change the focus here. It might help with, like, some of the lagginess. worth a shot. Alrighty. And then we're gonna get her to blow the something, and then we'll be able to get inside the tree. I'm going this way. Oh, shit!
Items.
Oh, so I should probably put items on.
Okay, so... Actually, how do you want me to teach you how to do this? Like, do you want to see me?
So, I got one to happen once, right?
Yeah.
Do I hit B at a certain time?
You hit A. Kind of like before or after you attack. Right. It's different person.
Can you do Silish Guards?
No. Okay. You can do B Guards, though, but the window is a lot smaller for those. Oh, that's gonna hurt you. But then they take damage if you guard correctly with a B Guard.
Okay, but it's harder to do than a normal guard.
Mm-hmm. Koops won't be able to do anything here. If you do want to keep Koops out, I would suggest just switching him with Mario. Just in terms of, like, where they're standing.
Oh, right. I think I can't do
Mario. Oh, that's true. Cute. Stylish points, though, add to your star power. There you go!
Nice.
They add to your star power so you don't have to waste turns of healing, so if you're always making stylish moves.
Oh, sick.
Yeah.
So, if, like, that lightning attack, if I had guarded that with B, could that still have hurt him, or does he have to physically touch me?
Gosh. I think it's still, no, he has to physically touch you.
Okay.
Maruto Fight is asking, does anyone know where I can buy a plushie of that cloud enemy? No, but you could probably make one.
Yeah, I bet you could hire someone on Etsy to make you one.
Definitely. Oh, I should bring my Mr. Saturn. I made a really cute little Mr. Saturn. And by little, I mean he's like this big. He's giant.
I know I got full star power, but...
Electrium says, would Paper Mario amiibos be 2D or 3D?
2D.
I agree. I think they should be 2D for sure, and have, like, a thick, dark line.
Could you even do... What would a 3D version of him look like?
Like, probably Mr. Game & Watch. Oh, wait, a 3D
I'm saying,
version?
Like,
oh!
If you made a 3D model of the like the art style of 2D Mario, it would just look like Mario with beady eyes, kind of, in, like, thick line art. Yeah, that's not who Paper Mario is. That's just Mario.
Are you okay?
Huh?
I don't know why I asked if you're okay. You're trying to, I don't remember how to kill that guy.
You know what I'm realizing now? Is I don't even know how he works. So, let's tattle him.
You can, What a rocker.
Fire doesn't hurt it, but other types of items are pretty effective. Nothing seems to work, you can always just run.
I would try Power Smash. I want to say I used to use Power Smash.
I did 1 damage to him at 1 point. Yeah.
The tree's gonna fall. I always think about, like, why is there a Paper Mario stage if we don't have any Paper Mario, or anybody, really?
Yeah, that's weird. In Smash, you mean?
Yeah. I'm not really sure why they... I mean, other than, like, they need another Mario stage in Paper Mario. It's a popular franchise that they're releasing more for, and... I mean, it's bad now, but people still go for the name. Oh, God.
I did it.
That was so close. That stressed me out so bad. Night Eater says Super Paper Mario is greater than Thousand Year Door, and then he said, well, not really, but it has Mr. L. Oh, Aziel's complimenting my bow. Well, he's saying it's anyone complimented my bow. It is a good bow. Thank you. But Mr. L was, I think, maybe the best part of Super Paper Mario. I'm still not a fan of it, though. The gameplay just doesn't do it for me.
He's like some sort of evil Luigi thing, right?
Yeah. It's fun because in Project M they have a costume for Luigi. We can be Mr. L. He looks angry in the little... Ice Climbers have the most adorable... Oh, True Friends bringing up my Mickey Mouse impression that I've been working on all weekend.
Yep, you've been practicing for the past 7 days.
It's kind of a joke, but it's also kind of not because I was at the beach just practicing my Mickey Mouse impression this weekend.
All right, here we go.
Oh, God.
Another great song. Those are some of the most conspicuous boobs I've ever seen on a Nintendo character.
Oh yeah, and they're bouncy. God, her music is incredible.
Everyone, this is kiss number three? What happened? Why did he pass out?
That was quite a kiss. Don't start.
Yawning?
Yeah, that's good.
Sorry. Plush mustache.
I do really like the way she talks.
Wow. Holy crap.
Mm-hmm.
New character.
Were you expecting that?
No, I didn't. I wasn't at all.
I always thought that Flurry's reveal scene reminded me a lot of, you didn't play Luigi's Mansion, but there is a ghost in the bathroom that looks like when the windows... Or, like, when the shower curtain's completely closed, you see her, like, showering. Mm. But you just see her silhouette, and she's, like, she looks, like, really skinny, and, like, she's, like, showering, she has, like, this pretty hair. And then you, like, use the poltergeist to actually pull the curtain back, and when you see her ghost, she's, like, this giant purple fat lady.
Huh. Another purple ghost.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, what the fuck? Official Pixelon says the,
I know, I'm reading this right now.
It's crazy. So the modding community found out that Game & Watch in Smash is a 3D model that they applied a shader to flatten him. So, yeah, I guess that's probably, like, how all Smash characters get flattened when they go to Game & Watch stages.
Mm-hmm.
Weird.
That is cool.
Hey, Adzel. It was his birthday yesterday.
Aww.
So we played Sonic Ball.
Really?
Have you seen Sonic Ball? I had not seen it before.
I saw like a picture of it.
Yeah.
On your Twitter, and I laughed, and I was like, "What's this? Nick's so silly." That's like how most of my day goes. Like I'll just scroll through Twitter and be like, "Oh, Nick."
She's a really that's a huge sprite. She's one of the like biggest characters in the game. I feel like.
Yeah. Well, there's a lot of bosses that are, like, Hooktail.
Right, yeah, I guess.
No, I can't wait till we get there. You know what I'm kind of upset about is how tiny Rosalina is.
Yeah?
Yeah, because, like, she's the same size as Peach Amiibo, but...
But she should be taller.
She should be giant, yeah. Like, Bowser takes up, like, the whole platform.
Let me grab this.
I mean, maybe...
Show people the Amiibo close.
Oh, again? Okay. If you guys haven't seen my Amiibo yet... We went way out of our way to get her. Look how pretty she is. There she goes. There's like a really super, it's not very noticeable, but there's like a super nice gradient on her dress. Back here. You can't really tell. But just, there's so much attention to detail in this amiibo. So good. I love her. And Luma's cute. I'm gonna put on a coat too.
Yeah, it's like cold. Or maybe it's just, like, the coffee is making me cold.
Why would coffee make you cold?
I don't know. I feel like sometimes when I'm really caffeinated, I start shivering.
Controversial. Seems like Rosalina is pretty divisive in the Twitch chat.
Why?
Oh, you see. That's a cool jacket. Holy shit.
Oh, thank you. That's a different scarf, too. Dang. Rosalina's the worst. Rosalina's best girl.
Yes.
Those are fighting words. Worst and best girl, and like, right next to each other. I am personally a huge fan of Rosalina. I don't know how you could say worst, but she's super important.
Body slam and gale force.
God, I don't know how to get Madame Fleury's stylish points. Oh, I have two Link too. I didn't bring him though. I should have done that. Yeah. He's so cute. His tunic has little like a little bit of texture. It's really nice. I'm so excited for Mega Man Amiibo.
They haven't shown it yet, have they?
Yeah.
Oh, they showed it during the Direct, I guess.
He's gonna be so cool. Supposedly, and I don't know about where, like, I don't know, everything's really tough right now with street dates, where they'll tell you, like, in our system, and I shouldn't talk about the system. But it says, like, some days it's coming out this day, and then it actually doesn't.
Right, yeah, there have been a lot of temporary dates.
So right now, I'm looking at Mega Man, like, being, like, I think the 21st. Where, like, I think the other ones are coming out, like, on Valentine's Day, supposedly. Wow, someone says there's a Babylonian subreddit.
Tight, yeah. I think I got a message about that right when we were getting started. That's rad.
Official Pixelon is telling us more cool stuff about, he said, did you hear the theory that Rosalina is Mario and Peach's future daughter? Wide speculation, but there's almost definite proof in the French release of Super Mario Galaxy that contains an extra storybook chapter that talks about Rosalina's father, who was proud of his mustache.
Is that true? Because that is, like, why would there be an extra storybook chapter in
just
the French version of Galaxy? Is that, like, a joke? I can't tell if that's a goof or not.
Night Eater 1, I just have to say, is you saying, I hope GameStop doesn't sell my Shulk Amiibo, and I get so many calls a day as if people being like, where's my Shulk Amiibo? Don't sell my Shulk Amiibo. It's not in yet. Don't worry. It won't get sold, probably. I mean, generally they get held for a lot longer because they're so rare. And also, it's 48 hours usually after a pre-order, but I want to say for Amiibos, we've been holding them for like a week. But yeah, don't worry. It's not.
Not gonna get sold.
It's coming.
Shulk.
Ooh, Gunslinger says, official Pixelon, Luigi also has a mustache.
True. See?
You know so who else has a mustache?
Waluigi.
Yeah, and Wario.
You know who else has a mustache is, Colonel White. Could be him.
General White?
General White.
General White. It's like, okay. It's
alright.
You know who else has a mustache? That toad that works in the shop?
Yes. Or a screaming mouth. I'm not going to read all that. If it was important, it would have forced me to read it.
Sean2173 says, Game Theory did a video where she's actually Luigi and Peach's daughter from another timeline.
Oof. Just dropping coins. Ah!
Oh my god, Universal just said, I had a guy come into EB Games begging my manager not to sell his Shulk, literally on his knees.
What the fuck are you doing here, dude?
Wow, Shadow Sands group creepy. PBNC says, why is GameStop selling people's amiibos or something? I don't. Shulk is a GameStop exclusive. Oh, there were rumors that they were selling them?
That's that totally gross guy, Dupree. What the heck is he doing here?
Because they're not even in yet, so I don't know how they could be selling them. Like, it's not even that they're not, that they're street dated. It's just, I don't know.
Jeez, Night Eater says that all of them so far.
Dang.
That's crazy. I saw a picture that someone put of all of them laid out side by side, and it was a sight to behold.
I have Rosalina, I have Toon Link, I only have the ones that I really wanted. I have Pit, and, God, Pit is the light of my life. And of course, Diddy Kong. Thank you.
You're welcome. Alrighty. I feel like I'm gonna die for some reason. I just feel like so tired or whatever. I just like, my body is falling apart right now.
I mean, you...
I'm not just trying to get out of learning stylish moves either.
Oh, it's totally fine.
But yeah, we've already been going for about 2 hours. I'd kind of be done around in a minute.
Okay, cool.
Jeez, my internet just dropped out again. Why?
Oh yeah, it did.
What is it doing? Anyway, alright. It's good now. Cool. Word. Well, but yeah. We made some good progress, I feel like. I'm glad we finally made it to that area.
Where are you going?
I'm just running around right now. cool. But yeah, I think that's probably it for today?
Yeah,
it
makes sense.
I gotta find a save block.
What time is it? I should probably go soon.
Yeah, it's like 2:40. Oh, jeez. A couple people in the Twitch chat just got back.
I know, I'm looking at it.
Sorry.
Sorry, guys.
The whole archive will be on immediately.
Other games today? We did make some progress here, but we did talk about... we talked more about, games and things we like.
That's fine, though. I think the chat enjoys that. I definitely do.
No, I do, too.
Alrighty, is there a save thing in this room? There's one over... I know where there is one.
Mm-hmm.
Alrighty. Before we wrap up, I'm gonna go get that that shine sprite.
That's a good idea before you forget.
Was this area chugging the first time we were here?
I don't think so.
Yeah, this is acting weird.
God, it pains me how bad you are at this.
The airplane?
Yeah.
There we go. You know. Jeez.
Life's rough.
Did it. Then where's the save block?
God, remember when I just got here and, a guy got hit by a car? I just keep thinking
Jesus,
about that.
Jesus, yeah.
I forgot that happened today. I have to go to work soon, too.
Yeah.
Fun.
All right, but yo, thank you guys for hanging out. I'll be back with Jenner at 8 p.m. Pacific Standard Time for Dramatic Murder Part 2. So,
sad look forward
to that. Yeah. You, one of these days, we'll line it up just right, and you'll be able to join us for that. But yo, yeah, thank you guys for hanging out. Andrea, thank you for coming again. This is the funnest part of my week, so.
Yes, me too, actually. I enjoy it.
Alrighty. Bye, everyone.
Bye, thanks for stopping by.